Optus' security systems will undergo an independent forensic investigation as the telco revealed the extent of the major data breach. Let's go live to Federal Politics reporter Rhys D'Alessandro. Rhys, good morning to you. How many people have had their IDs stolen?
Hey Carl, good morning to you. According to the Optus CEO, 2.1 million customers. The telco has drawn criticism in recent days from senior federal government ministers for what some have described as a lack of cooperation, but the Optus CEO has hit back, suggesting that attack was premature, telling Nine newspapers in terms of providing the government with the information it requested, Optus was working to a deadline of today. In the meantime, though, Carl, the telco has launched its own independent review, as you mentioned, into the major cyber attack that exposed the data of nearly 10 million customers, a forensic investigation into the telco's security systems to be carried out by consulting firm Deloitte. It's also becoming clearer exactly how many customers have been badly impacted. Take a listen.
We're now in a position to say that 7.7 million customers do not need to take further action. 2.1 million customers have had an identity document number exposed where they may need to take action.
Of those 2.1 million personal identification details stolen, 150,000 passport numbers are included and 50,000 Medicare numbers. Worth noting too, Carl, we understand Optus will not publish the Deloitte review in full and hasn't yet given a deadline for when it will be completed.
Rhys, thank you.
And to add insult to injury, this is what frustrated customers in Perth are copping right now, forced to line up for hours to replace driver's licences that have been caught up in the hack. Let's go to Jack Hahn. Jack, good morning to you. People are scrambling to protect their information.
Yeah, g'day, Alex. That's right. Perth residents yesterday were forced to take time out of their own busy work days to get a replacement licence. And while the Mark McGowan government will cover the tab for the replacement IDs, many West Aussies paid with their own time. As you could imagine, they were very frustrated. Take a listen.
I had to leave work to come down, sort this out.
With the people like me working full time, it's very hard to get this thing sorted straight away.
It is very, very upset.
Angry for good reason. Some of these lines stretched up for 100 people, and reports are that some lines, the wait time on it was 2 hours, Alex.
Not good, Jack. Thanks so much.